Hey, question 10. A lot of words, but I'm going to kind of show you how, before I start reading it, what I would do is, okay, I'm going to look at the picture. We got two triangles. We got a couple angles here at the top. We've got hypotenuses here, so I've got that. Something meters, so they want a length of a side. So they're either going to want how far is this person from this, or they want to know how long it is, one of those two. And so let's go ahead. What I start is based on these measurements, find the length of the entire tunnel. So now I know I'm looking for sort of the base of these two triangles. And what I'm going to need to do is find, there's really two problems, and then I'm going to add the two bases together from what it's telling me. So what I'm seeing, I've got an angle, I've got a hypotenuse, and I'm looking for an opposite side, right? An opposite side. So I did that all with the visual, tried to cut out the words, but now let's see. A surveyor wants to know the tunnel. He's located 243 meters from one entrance of the tunnel at an angle 47. Okay, so this is just telling us all the information about the picture. But the main thing is, what are we trying to find? So now that I know what we're trying to find this total distance. I can set up my picture and do the calculation. So I'm gonna need this triangle. I'm gonna separate them just so it's clear. 243, and this is 47. The thing is, to me, how does he know all this information? Why doesn't he just measure the tunnel? I always, but again, there's probably a reason. So these are how surveyors work. And then how do you know you're 186? Maybe you could walk it off, I guess. Let's see what we end up with, though. 27 degrees. So again, what we're trying to find is sort of like we'll call this x little one and maybe x little two or something. We're trying to find these two values, and then we're going to add them together to get the total length of the tunnel. Total. There we go. So this is a hypotenuse. We have the angle. We're looking for an opposite, an OPP. And in both cases, so that's always going to be sine of, well, in this case, sine of 47 is equal to the opposite, the OPP, over the hypotenuse, 243. So you'll see we just multiply both sides by 243. Don't have to do the inverse sine because we have the angle. Again, emphasize we've got degrees. So that's going to be the first opposite. So that's x2. Same thing's going to happen over here. We're going to want the sine of 27 degrees, and that's going to be equal to the opposite. And this time I'll go ahead and just call that x1 over the hypotenuse. So multiply both sides by 186. You're going to get 186 sine of 27 degrees. That's what's equal to x1. We're going to get those two numbers, we're going to add them together, and we're going to be done. Just like that. So I'll do this one first since it's showing up. So we got, and we're in degree mode, always do that check. 186 sine of 27 degrees. So that's our first side is 84.4. 4.2, and then we'll round at the end. So it's always a good idea to put some extra decimal places. Now it's 2.243 sine of 47. Okay, so clear that. 2.43, it's right there, sine of 47. Add that one, 177.719. Plus 177.719. We'll round it to three decimal places. Let's see, what does the question ask for? Do not round your answers to the nearest tenth when we're done. Okay, so pull back up the calculator. 177.719 plus 84.4. 442, just to be safe. And then the nearest tenth is 262.1. The six rounds it up, so 262.2. 262.2. That's what we got. All right. And it sort of makes sense. I guess you've got these meters. Again, it's not drawn to scale, but with what we were given, it would seem reasonable. It fits with the triangles, right? If this is 243, it's a hypotenuse. This side has to be less than 243. It was 177. If this is 186, it's a hypotenuse. This side has to be less than that. It's 84. It's reasonable. Anyway, so the reasonableness check. Good, that's 10.